Welcome to Second Take, the show that takes a look at the issues behind the news. An expansion of the Gautrain rail system has long been planned, and the Gautrain Management Agency is seeking approval from the National Treasury to proceed with the project. Irma tells us more. Hi, Irma.
Hi, Chanel.
Why is the proposed expansion necessary, and what will it entail?
Well, already Gauteng has got a massive problem in terms of traffic. I mean, Gautrain Management Agency CEO Jack van Amerva says about 547 people show up in Gauteng every day from the rest of South Africa. So we're talking about rapid urbanization. So we've got a huge problem in terms of pressure being put on the road system and on the rail system and basically every kind of transport system that we have in Gauteng. So what we need to do is then obviously to expand our transport system, and the rail is an important part of this. In fact, the Gauteng government has said that they think rail should be the backbone of public transport in Gauteng. So we have this real need to expand the network and to be able to put more people on it. At the moment, it's kind of running at capacity in terms of peak hours, which is why the GMA, the Gautrain Management Agency, already have to put in extra rolling stock, which will hopefully be in place, we hope, maybe this year, maybe next year, maybe even a little bit later. But we have to put in extra rolling stock to deal with that peak capacity that we've got. So the expansion basically looks at putting in 150 kilometers of extra rail and about 19 stations. So hopefully that will expand the system, especially in what Jack van Amerva says is a specific node of pressure, which is from Randburg into Sandton.
The expansion is often referred to as Gautrain 2, but it may differ from the existing Gautrain system.
That's all linked to a bit of politics at the moment. So what we've got is we've got two rail systems in Gauteng at the moment. We've got the Prasa Metro rail system, and then we've got the Gautrain. And already Gauteng MEC for Transport, Dr. Ishmael Vadi, has said that it's difficult to have these two systems with two management systems and two different operating systems. Wouldn't it make sense, he asked, just to have one specific system? So what's happening now at a legislation level is that there's a new national rail policy that's looking at maybe devolving rail down to municipal level or even provincial level. But I mean, that's all up in the air still. It's just a proposal. So, but while this is being sorted out, and while the Gauteng government also seems to be pushing for one management system for rail, I think it's difficult to typify and say that would be Gautrain 2 or that would be an extension of the Gautrain. So while everybody talks about the extension of the Gautrain, and they call it the Gautrain 2, it can actually be branded Metrorail, it could be branded Prasa, it could be branded a completely new entity for Gauteng Rail, or it could be branded Gautrain. So we're not sure at the moment, and while that's all up in the air, I think we're just, everybody's talking about Gautrain 2, but it's not necessarily clear whether it will be exactly an extension of the Gautrain.
How will the expansion be funded?
Well, that's the big problem at the moment as well. You know, government is a tight economy. Government doesn't have a lot of money. So what Jack van Amerva proposes is that the system, the new additions, 150 kilometer, be broken down into five kind of palatable bits and pieces that then is built bit by bit. So we build one section, then we build another section, then we build another section, and that this be funded proportionally then as well, or funded as the project progresses. So this would make sense, and then government can push a little bit more money into that every time. It doesn't have to have this huge chunk of money available up front to build 150 kilometers of rail. Because make no mistake, this will be an expensive system. If you think that was 30 billion rand, just short of 30 billion rand for the initial Gautrain system, this is 150 kilometers for versus 80 kilometers for the initial Gautrain system. This will also involve tunneling. Well, going from Randburg into Sandton, you will need to tunnel. Going to Soweto, for example, you'd need to expropriate some land, so that will be expensive. What, however, is a benefit that you can definitely say at the moment is that it's no longer an unknown. The Gautrain system is a very known system. It's a very desirable transport system. I mean, studies have shown that it is the most desirable mode of transport within public transport within Gauteng. So people will, there's no more this risk factor, will people like the Gautrain? Will they take the Gautrain? It is very popular, people will take it, so you don't have to price that risk in. And you also know that the stations will be development nodes. I mean, the Gautrain generated around 49 billion rand in developments around their station, just the initial system. So if you add another 19 stations, you think what kind of economy you can create around these stations as you broaden the scope of the Gautrain. So that will also generate some money. So there's a lot of knowns now that can maybe negotiate the actual price of the Gautrain down a little bit and make it a more palatable system for government to finally implement.
Thank you. That's the Second Take Show for this week. Thank you for watching and join us again next time for more news analysis.